We've worked really hard over the last decade to make sure the ACT is doing its part to tackle the global issue of climate change. We're a small jurisdiction, but we have a jurisdiction with a high level of emissions per capita. As a developed country, a wealthy city in that developed country, we've got a big climate footprint, and we need to make sure we're cutting our emissions. That's why we've moved the ACT to get all of its electricity 100% from renewable sources. This is a city that is dominated by the car. Whilst public transport, walking and cycling will be part of the story of cutting our emissions, we also need to make sure our car fleet is a clean car fleet.
Our project REVS, which stands for Realising Electric Vehicle to Grid Services, is internationally significant because of the close collaboration between the auto industry and the transport industry.
The REVS project is an ARENA-funded project that brings together ActuAGL, Evo Energy, the ACT government, JetCharge, SG Fleet, Nissan, who provide the vehicles, and the ANU, to evaluate and demonstrate the value that electric vehicles can provide beyond transport.
In REVS, we're using the energy stored in the batteries of 51 Nissan Leafs here in the ACT to support the security and stability of the electricity grid. And when there's an unexpected mismatch, such as when a storm knocks at a power station, the vehicles jump in and provide power from their batteries into the grid in a matter of seconds to help restore that balance.
I think if you just imagine in your head all of these vehicles that are plugged into the wall as being pivotal assets for the electricity grid, think of them as beating hearts that provide an alternative to any other kind of grid support. You can use them to drive, you can use them to power your homes and buildings, and you can use them to support our electricity infrastructure.
So effectively the car becomes an energy asset, not dissimilar to a battery on the wall of the house.
So this small charger allows us to both charge our electric vehicle and also discharge power out of the vehicle into the home or the grid, or in our case into the lab. And what this switchboard represents is a switchboard in an average Australian home. So in this switchboard we can have connected solar that's coming in from the roof, and that solar power can then go out and power the electric vehicle charger. And with vehicle to grid, that electric vehicle can then also discharge power back into the switchboard to be used in the home.
As Nissan, we've been really early adopters of not only electric vehicles with the first mass market, mass produced electric vehicle in the Leaf, but also that's transitioned through into being really early innovators in the vehicle to grid technology. So we've been active in lots of markets around the world with different trial programs across Japan, across Europe, and really integrating vehicles more into the grid and into the energy system.
But it also will help on those days where there's big spikes in electricity demand. We can use all of these batteries to offset that.
This, coupled with the value from the energy market, we're able to pass through and create incentives back to the electric vehicle owners.
All of a sudden, your electric vehicle is not only helping you reduce your emissions from transport, reducing your petrol costs, but also helps you maximise the renewable energy you're generating and support the wider grid as well.
That would be amazing. That means your car would essentially be the most efficient asset that you have. It hopefully means lowering the price of electricity for everybody.
The future's coming towards us incredibly fast. The rate of innovation in Australia is really exciting. It's also slightly daunting. We've got a lot to do in a short amount of time. But I've got real confidence that the new technologies like vehicle to grid and all the other bits of work that are being done means that we can move to a zero emission electricity supply in Australia much more quickly than some have suggested. The technology's there, the know-how's there. We've now just got to have the courage to get on and do it.
We're going to see new incentives, business models and opportunities open up. But most importantly, it's going to help reduce the total cost of ownership of those vehicles by providing a steady revenue stream.
For households, V2G is transformational because now you'll have 2 to 3 days worth of electricity parked in your garage.
The thing that gets me the most excited is vehicle to grid or vehicle to X allows us to see the convergence between the energy side of the world and the transport side of the world. What that means for everyday drivers is the ability to achieve almost complete autonomy from both an electricity consumption perspective and also from a transportation perspective. So in a world where all of us or most of us have solar, you are able to charge your vehicle with that solar and then at night, plug that vehicle in and power your house with it. That level of freedom has never existed before, and it's something that we're really looking forward to.